Hello and welcome. We're going to solve this problem together, but first I suggest that you pause the video and give it a shot on your own. You might be surprised what you can do. Okay, so this question is, which graph represents a function? And in order to answer this question, what we need to understand is what a function is in its most essential form. What a function tells us, what a function does, I should say, is that every input leads to one output. That's the idea of a function. So every input you have, every starting point as your input, usually the x, leads to one output, usually the y value. Now, as a graph, what that translates to is points. Every point is made up of x and y. In other words, every point has an input, x, and an output, y. So this means that in order for a graph to be a function, all of your points, right, every point's input has to only lead to one output. And this leads us to our answer. And what you can see is that graph C is not a function. Let's look at y. I'll pull out these two points here and here. And this point on top, this point up here, is 1 and up 3, so it's 1, 3. And this point here is 1, negative 2. Right? So let's look at these two points, and we'll list them out over here. 1, 3, and then 1, negative 2. So if we get a sense of what's happening here, we see that the number 1 is our input, and it has an output of 3. So far, it's okay. But then, again, 1, the same input, leads to a different output. So in a sense, this input leads to two different outputs. One is going to both 3 and negative 2. This can't happen. This is not a function. This is a relationship of some other sorts. So this graph is not a function. And what you typically might hear is that what you can do, if you know, this is important, if x is your input and y is your output, sometimes that can be switched. If you draw that line and it crosses your graph more than one time, this is called the vertical line test. It's showing you that the graph is not a function. So you can use that vertical line test if x is your input and y is your output. All right, thanks.